Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is just going to be a quick little makeup look, like if you don't want to wear too much makeup, if you don't want to not wear any makeup at all. Even though everyone should feel comfortable in their own skin. So here we are, let's get started. First I'm going to take my Nivea Post Shave Balm that I heard about from Nick Tutorials. It's super popular on YouTube right now, a lot of makeup artists have been using it. I'm just going to rub it into my hands for a little bit, damp it all over my face. I don't know about you guys, but I love where this smells. It smells very masculine. It makes me feel like I'm with a hot guy. Sounds bad because I have a boyfriend, but this makes me feel like I'm sexy and y'all ain't ready for me. You know what I'm saying? Next, I'm going to take a MAC Studio Finish Concealer. I mentioned this in a video before. It's super full coverage, super thick. It's not for everyone. It's for me. And I'm taking a little concealer brush that I've had since I was like in high school. From Sephora brand. I don't remember how much I paid for it because it was so long ago, but I'm just gonna take it, dip it into there, and I'm gonna apply it in all of my T-zone. Now I'm just gonna take my fingers and just blend it all in. This concealer is so creamy and so thick, so I feel like that's the best way to do it. My hands are clean, so I think it's okay. Next, I'm going to take my Kat Von D Lock It Foundation in color. I don't know what color it is. And I'm going to take a MAC 190. I'm gonna put a squirt on there. Squirt and a half. Just gonna powder it along. Wish that I could stay forever. Now I'm gonna take an e.l.f. powder brush, $3 brush, and just blend that out. Life's a game made for everyone. And love is the prize. So wake me up when it's all over. Take my Studio Fix in color C5. I'm just gonna apply it over my foundation. I like a bit more cakier, powdery look. So. So I have two e.l.f. angled brushes. I bought them both for my eyebrows. I marked one up with tape because it's the one I'm going to use for Anastasia's brow dip, and then this one I'm going to use for Urban Decay's Brow Box Powder. I'm going to dip this in here, stab it on, and then I'm going to outline my eyebrow. And then I outlined all of my eyebrow except for the part in the middle because I like that to have a little more of a fade and not be so defined in that area. So now I'm going to take my other e.l.f. angled brush and I'm going to take Urban Decay's Brow Box. I've had this for at least 2 years and it's nowhere near hitting the pan yet. Just going to take that powder, knock the excess off, and just fill in my eyebrows like so. Now because I'm doing a very light makeup look, I'm going to take a Naked palette and Urban Decay Primer Potion to do a very simple eyeshadow look. I'm not going to make it defined, I'm not going to make it super dramatic, it's going to be very subtle. Take my Primer Potion, put it on my fingers. It's a lot, way too much. Now I'm going to take the Urban Decay Naked palette. Thing is old and rusty. Going to take the Naked 2 brush that it came with. I'm going to take the color Sin, the second color from the side. I'm gonna apply that all over my lids. I'm going to take another e.l.f. brush that I bought, like, probably at, like, the dollar store. It's just a simple brush. I really like e.l.f. brushes because they get the job done. I'm going to take the fourth color from the end of the palette called Sidecar, and I'm going to apply that all over my crease. Now I'm going to go back in with that e.l.f. brush that I recently had, the Duo Tip one, from the Naked 2 palette. I'm just going to blend those together just to give me a natural yet blended look that you can't really tell if I'm wearing eyeshadow for sure or not. Now you can see what I mean, a very subtle look where it's just a little bit of shimmer in my eye. Now, I know a lot of people do their eyeshadow first because of all the fallout, but I don't mind the fallout. I clean it up anyways. Now that I'm getting closer to being done and I'm noticing my lips are so chapped, I'm going to go ahead and apply my favorite chapstick, EOS Eggs. Next, I'm going to take my NARS Radiant Concealer in the color Honey, and I'm going to apply that all under my under eye in a triangular shape. Next, I'm going to take my Knock Off Beauty Blender that I got from Walgreens, and I'm just going to lightly dab that and knock off all the extra fallout I have from the eyeshadow and just dab away. Next, I'm going to take my Anastasia Contour Kit, and I'm going to apply some colors under my eye to give me more of a radiant glow. As you can tell, I use this palette so much. I'm going to mix these two and I'm going to apply them under my eye. Surprise, surprise, another e.l.f. brush. I'm going to take it in the color Raisin from MAC and apply that on my cheeks because it's a bronzy kind of day. Next, I'm going to take my Sephora angled brush. I don't remember when I bought this. It was probably a long time ago. In the number 130, that's what it says, so that's what I'm going to believe it is. And I'm going to take Becca's Champagne Pop, the highlighter of the year, and Glow for the Gods. I'm just going to dab that in there and just apply that right above my bronzer. Now I'm going to take my blush brush that I used earlier for the bronzer, and I'm just going to go back over it. I'm not going to dip it back in, just adding a little bit more bronzer over so the glow isn't like too strong over the bronzer. Next, I'm going to take another e.l.f. brush. It's an e.l.f. Kabuki brush, and I'm just going to blend everything together. Take an NYC lip liner, and I'm just going to apply that all around the side of my lips so I can outline them. Now I'm going to take my go-to MAC lipstick for a regular everyday look, Persistence. It's a very reddish undertone nude color. Just apply that all over my lips. personally, I get my eyelashes done. I get lash extensions. I've been doing it for about 7 months now. It's the best thing you can ever invest in because it's like on the go. Sometimes I do miss wearing falsies. You always can, but then it'll mess them up. Sometimes if you know what you're doing, it won't. But I'm just going to leave my top lashes alone and I'm going to apply falsies mascara to the bottom lashes. Oh, do I have mascara under the bottom of my eye? It's okay, because to me, it looks like I try to smoke it out, and I like the way it looks. Gives me a good little look that I like. Now I'm going to take a jumbo eyeliner that I have. I don't know the brand because it's faded off, but this thing has been with me for years, and it's still super good. I'm just going to apply that on my waterline. Now I'm going to take an NYC eyeliner and just apply it to the top of my lid. And like I said, because it's a basic look that I'm going for, I'm not going to make sure that it's super perfect. Just going to apply it on the top. My last step that I'm going to do is I'm going to take a spoolie and just brush out my eyelash extensions just to make sure they're where they're supposed to be. So here's the finished makeup look. I hope you guys liked my video. I hope I taught you something, gave you some tips that you might enjoy. That's really all I have to say for right now. So hopefully you subscribe to my channel and like my video. See you guys next time. Seeing you, see me.